Barbarian! 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 Barbarian!
The Barbarian! Huge Barbarian! His sisters Bang and Candy are a princess and a chimp!
A land rich in history, from its founding by Wrong Way Gribble, who mistakenly believed he had discovered the South Pole, to the tragedy known forever as the Night of the Hamsters. The story of Udrogoth is one of heroism and unpleasant rodents. Each year, this story is retold in the Pageant of Udrogoth.
It is a great honor to have been chosen to direct the pageant.
Because no one else wanted to.
And I take this honor very seriously. Now, if you'll excuse me, let the auditions begin!
Oh, hi. My name is Girkbug Melon, 1M, 1L, and I'll be auditioning for the part of tree number 2. Mamada babada, mamada babada, mamada babada.
Yes! Woo! We'll be in touch. Next!
Hi, Dave. I'm trying out for the part of the princess. Like, duh.
Oh, my beloved Wrong Way Gribble, why bringest thou to this warm land so many parkas? Surely thy...
Yes, very nice, but I'd like to see you in a different role.
Exotic Duchess, the glamorous queen.
Tree number 2. Yes! Wow! We'll be in touch. Next! Let me guess, you're trying out for tree number 2.
Tree number 1? I don't play bit parts.
But at this very moment, our heroes are interrupted by... a dark old Chuckles, the silly piggy!
Now, foolish barbarians, you will all be destroyed by my fearsome pretzel men! The pretzel men will upend you!
Are you kidding with this?
Of course not! My terrifying pretzel men will obliterate you!
But seriously, what are you really going to attack us with?
I am serious! Gaze upon the dread visages of my pretzel men and... and tremble at your inescapable doom.
Pretzel men.
What was I thinking? Attack!
But Chuckles' fiendish threat is thwarted by the mighty Oswidge.
I'll handle this.
With your magic?
No, with a little mustard. Come on, pretzel men. Papa skipped lunch today.
Hooray! We're gonna be eaten!
Yay, Oswidge swiftly disposes of the delicious salty menace.
Ah, what a great bunch of guys.
I'm so very tired.
Hey, Piggy! I almost hate to do this after that lame-o attack, but pull the string.
That's just typical. I skim my little piggy knees.
And thus are Chuckles' evil plans foiled once more. Later, back in his evil fortress, Chuckles bemoans his tragic fate.
2 pickles, a ketchup packet, something green that probably used to be meat. Nothing! Evil villainy just ain't putting food on the table. This is all because of Dave the Barbarian and his sweaty little family. Ooh, how I dislike them! They have foiled my evil plans again and again and again. And again and again and again and again! When I think of it, I get so mad the screen goes all wiggly! Now you will all be destroyed by my fearsome killer snail!
You really don't see the flaw in this plan, do you?
Flaw? There's no flaw!
But Chuckles has forgotten the famous Udrogoth salt mine! The giant snail is swiftly dissolved by the salt, and its shell later used as low-income housing.
Now you will all be destroyed by my fearsome killer octopus!
But Chuckles has forgotten an important fact about octopi.
Blink!
Their eyesight is terrible.
Now you will all be destroyed by my fearsome killer sectional sofa with matching end tables!
That upholstery is hideous.
But once again, Chuckles has forgotten something important.
What is it this time?
Sectional sofas are inanimate objects designed for comfort and therefore totally harmless.
Nothing. Why do I keep looking in the fridge when I know there's nothing there? Oh, I am so lame. Lamey.
And as Chuckles agonizes over the state of his career, Dave begins rehearsals for the pageant of Woodragoth.
All right. Not as many people auditioned for this epic extravaganza as I'd hoped. So you six will have to play all 914 roles.
I would like to play the Grim Reaper, who comes to collect the souls of the deceased.
There's no Grim Reaper in this script.
I can improvise.
What about me?
You'll be the stage manager.
Which means?
You get to yell at everyone.
Works for me.
Okay, people, let's get to work! This is the job I was born to do.
And back in Chuckles' evil fortress...
How can I defeat those barbarians? Oh, I could try a killer dachshund. Oh, a killer avocado! A killer decorative toilet paper roll cover! No, blah, blah, blah! No, it's time for a different approach! What do all my previous defeats have in common? Think about it.
And yea, Chuckles ponders this problem with all the monumental porcine brain power he can bring to bear. What do his previous defeats have in common? What? Oh, for the love of heaven, what?
I know! It's you!
Me?
Yes! I mean, you always say, Dave boldly foils the evil piggy's plan or something, and then it happens! Do you realize what this means?
I have a way with words.
You, the storyteller, are the master of destiny!
Golly!
He who controls the storyteller controls the universe! Behold the mystic chains of encumbrance! Now that you are bound by the mystic chains, you must do as I command!
Yes, O Master.
Let's see now. How can I test this? Ooh, I know! Okay, storyteller, my first command is that you read this.
As you say, O Master, it is a dark and stormy night. The mighty Dark Lord Chuckles devises his fiendish plans in his luxurious palace of evil.
Sweet!
With its fully stocked refrigerator.
Ooh, I like to eat.
Dressed in his fabulous designer evil cape.
Ooh la la!
And shows off his bulging, manly physique.
Now that's more like it. Oh, yeah, who's your daddy? I am the perfect, manliest piggy
of them all. La, 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 la.
And now I will defeat Dave the Barbarian at last. Read this, my good storyteller. Read it because I won't give it to you.
Yes, O Master. Meanwhile, Dave is working on the pageant of Woodragoth.
Let's begin with the big opening number. Have we all learned it?
I have.
Excellent. Begin!
Oh, what could be more nasty or more crusty or more ghastly than our glorious Woodragoth?
So though across the world I roam, I never feel too far from home. If I can but with the fragrance of a thousand unwashed vagrants.
No Shangri-La or paradise could be even half as nice as our glorious
Ta-da! Yes! Woo!
That is, without a doubt, the worst song I ever heard.
We're out of here.
But you... How...
See ya, kiddo.
Well, at least I've still got Mrs. Bogmelon and Twinkle the Marvel Horse.
Is it all right if all I do in the show is groan in agony?
Hey, how much did you say this gig pays?
No. And nothing.
I'm gone.
Me too.
Wait! Who'll do my show?
Just then, our heroes are once again visited by... the Pretzel Men!
Oh, I needed a good laugh. Hey, guys, come back here. It's the pretzel men.
Oh, goody. I can do with a snack.
Up to our hero's shock, the pretzel men transform into savage warriors.
The jabbers.
The pretzel men seize our heroes in their salt-encrusted talons and...
Go on, storyteller. Read what I wrote for you.
Well, I can't. This is far too violent for a family show.
Fine. Let's see. I'll take out this bit and this bit and... Ooh, that is pretty nasty. Okay. All right. How about this?
That should be all right. Cut to exterior of castle. The pretzel men do non-specific but presumably very unpleasant things to our heroes off camera.
Happy-doo-doo-doo. Well, go on. Read the last part.
Thus, the Dark Lord chuckles the silly piggy does once and for all defeat our dumb, stinky old heroes.
Victory is mine at last!
Has Dave the Barbarian really been beaten? Is Udrugoth now ruled by Chuckles? Will he soon conquer the entire world? Does Turkey have less fat than chicken?
You bet your sweet little keister! I said the word keister!
We'll be right back. While you're waiting, why not pledge eternal loyalty to the Dark Lord Chuckles the Silly Piggy? It's fun! We rejoin our former heroes who have been utterly defeated by Chuckles the Silly Piggy and who are extremely smelly.
Neener, neener, neener! I am smart and you are dumb! You eat dirt and suck your thumb!
But you can't win! I always win! I'm the hero!
Not anymore, me bucko, because I control the storyteller.
The storyteller? You can't do that.
Oh, but I have, Mr. Smarty. And as of right now, I'm taking over this show. Taking over the show. Hit it, Maestro. Silly piggy, the silly piggy. Silly piggy, the silly piggy. The Dark Lord chuckles the silly piggy.
We join our hero, Chuckles the Silly Piggy, as he prepares for another day of tormenting his foes.
So, what'll I do to you today?
This is terrible.
You bet it is! We're about to be nothing but little barbarian-flavored smears!
And I'll never get to direct the pageant of Udrugoth. Alas!
I hate you so much right now.
What? Ooh, I know! I could roast you over a volcano.
No!
Lock you in a cage with rabid dung beetles.
No, please!
Call you in the middle of dinner and try to convince you to switch long-distance carriers.
Yes, that would be evil indeed.
But even that is not enough, my spongy and impertinent foes. No, I must humiliate you completely.
Oh, spare us.
No way, Jose. Let's see. If I'm not allowed to do anything violent on a family show, then how can I do this? Aha! Narrate away, my fine faceless friend.
At this very moment, Castle Udrugoth is bulldozed and replaced by a Captain Smacky's Fish and Chips franchise. The kingdom of Udrugoth is annihilated by a gigantic sausage! Not a pork sausage either, turkey or chicken or something. Meanwhile, Dave and the other barbarian jerks cower before the Dark Lord, wearing big silly-looking hats and making dumb noises like the big dumb fishy pinheads they are.
Now that you have been properly humiliated, all that remains is to wipe you off the face of the earth like icky boogery things. Storyteller, if you please.
And so, And so, the majestic and handsome Dark Lord raises... excuse me. Raises high his awesome mystic amulet, and with one mighty... mighty blast completely and utterly destroys
the barbarians! Go ahead, say it! Read my lips! Destroys the barbarians! Oh, he has laryngitis! Lozenges! I need lozenges! A lozenge! My kingdom for a lozenge!
The storyteller guy lost his voice. Now's our chance!
To rehearse the pageant of Voodragoth?
Try again.
To rehearse the pageant of...
Jay!
Okay. It's time to kick Chuckle's wee piggy rump.
Obviously, you guys haven't been paying attention to how the show works. We can't beat Chuckles, and he can't beat us.
Why?
Because there's no storyteller. And without a storyteller, the story can't end.
He's got a point, and not just on his hat.
In that case, there's only one thing to do. Hold auditions!
Jay! Would you forget that stupid pageant?
No. I mean, I've got to hold auditions for a storyteller of our own.
Hey, that's kind of not dumb.
You guys keep Chuckles busy. I'll be right back. So... how would you tell the story of the heroic barbarians defeating the evil piggy?
I don't have a script.
Who needs a script? Improvise, make it up. Thrill me.
Well, all right. Once upon a time, there lived a jolly little pig named Chuckles. Chuckles skipped along merrily through the land of happy good cheer.
With a hey-hi, dingle-dangle-ho, dingle-hey, with a hey-hi, dingle-dangle-hum.
One day, he met some sunny, happy-go-lucky barbarians who gave him cake and ice cream.
Yay!
And they all lived happily ever after in a hollow pumpkin in the old oak tree.
Next! And how would you tell this story?
Sunday! Nitro Burning Barbarian Monster Truck Demolition Derby Free-for-All! Be there!
Next! Yeah, tell me a story.
In this soulless pit of atrocities we call life, to each of us must come agonizing torments.
Thank you, we'll be in touch.
But I haven't gotten to the part about the shrieking maggots of grief yet.
I said thank you! Hey, guys! I found someone! You guys been keeping Chuckles busy?
Yep.
No, it's Toto, heel.
You don't want to mess up the pageant's Chuckles' glorious victory scene, do you?
No! Come on, let's do it again! I got it! The time for tap dancing is at an end, fiendish piggy! I give you our new storyteller!
Are you ready for a futuristic space adventure?
I see. And obviously, you've written a script for him to read in which you defeat me.
Gosh, that would have been a good idea. I just figured I'd let him make up his own story.
Jay!
Aha! Then you might not be the hero of this story. I still have a chance to destroy you.
Welcome to the heroic exploits of Dave the Space Barbarian.
A slight chance.
Today's episode, Chuckles gets beat like a cheap drum.
I'm doomed.
We join our space heroes as they patrol the galaxy of Alpha Udragoth.
Captain Dave, evil space piggy at 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock? That's hours from now.
Space Navigator Baffy. Run away!
Captain Dave, you gotta fight that piggy!
Me? Don't we have space robots to do that kind of thing?
All we got is smarter now that he's a robot. I think his brain's recycled from an old video game.
Meanwhile, the evil space lord arms his space lasers for combat.
What's the point? I already know I'm gonna lose.
I said the evil space...
All right! Hey, that's pretty nifty!
The space lord pursues our heroically fleeing space heroes and thus begins a pitched space battle in space. Just look at that exciting space action. Sunk, sahui, bam, booma, booma, booma. But just as it seems no one can hit the side of a space barn, the space lord scores a direct space hit on our space hero's space generator.
And our space space engines power the space lasers?
I'm pushing her as hard as I can, Captain. She'll not take the strain.
Isn't there some kind of convenient techno-babble thing that can save us? Like, if we reverse the polarity of the protonic crystal to disrupt his quantum field matrix?
Sorry, Captain. Convenient techno-babble levels are dangerously low.
Thinking quickly, Dave devises a plan. A plan that will put him in terrible danger.
No, no, no!
Yes, Dave will launch himself into space like a space torpedo.
Space pajabras.
Dave has but one chance. He can destroy the Space Lord's spaceship with Lula the Space Sword.
But Space Captain Dave, how can we destroy such an enormous spaceship?
Ask the freak who's making up this story.
Fortunately, as everyone knows, all evil spaceships have a weak point.
I hope this isn't going to make a loud bang. My ears are tender.
Just do it, Space for Brains!
He found our weak point! Ooh, I knew I shouldn't have labeled it!
And with a tremendous space burst of space energy, the spaceship is space destroyed! Space.
Curse you, Dave! The space!
Later, after I've gotten my voice back and been freed of the mystic chains of encumbrance, Dave's spectacular pageant of Udragoth is at last ready to open.
It's good to have you back, Mr. Storyteller.
It's good to be back, Dave.
And those mystic chains came in real handy. Without them, I'd never been able to stage the pageant.
Big loss.
Shh! It's starting!
I am not gonna sing that stupid
mystic chains of encumbrance!
Yes, oh, master! Oh, what could be more nasty or more crusty or more ghastly than our glorious Udragoth?
That is one talented pig.
You said it, bro.
As our glorious Udragoth!
Take the plunge under the sea with Ariel, Sebastian, and Flounder in The Little Mermaid. Coming up next, here on Disney Channel.